welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Georgia has lined up for the kickoff, and we're ready to get this one underway. Fielded at the four. Brought down at the 25. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. And down he goes, right around the 26-yard line. Taken down at the 27. The halfback picks up a yard. Now he's scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Tackle around the 38-yard line.
Hey, sometimes the defense does everything right, and they still lose. That time they had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the quarterback to take off.
Make the stop at the 46-yard line. That'll bring up second and three. Tackle made at the 49-yard line. And the short gain is enough for the first.
And that tailback definitely has a nose for that first down marker.
Makes it out to about the 43. That's a that makes it second. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Gets to about the 41-yard line. Bring him down to 39-yard line. Fires it out. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. He's tackled at the 29.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
We're at the 12th play of the drive. Receiver's got the first down, and that sets them up with a first and goal.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back the pass.
Looking to scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure. From the 14-yard line, second down. They run it left. Gets to about the 11-yard line.
Look for
second down at the one. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. He steps out at the 5-yard line.
Illegal touching. Offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still first down.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He makes it to the 9. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. They line up at the 9. It's second down. On play action. He's in trouble. Got a man. Watch out here. He's out to the 30. Brought down at about the 35. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 35-yard line.
Three down. Check 26.
Fires incomplete. He was looking for the tight end.
Here's a case of a quarterback so eager to make a play that he failed to see the danger of that attempt and nearly gave the ball away.
Tight end, but he bottles the ball away. It's third down and 10. Ball on their own 35. Quick throw. And down he goes at the 46. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. Throws complete. He's hammered.
That'll make it second and 4.
Quick throw out to the receiver. He's taken down at the 32. This is the 8th play of this drive. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. Tackle around the 29-yard line. We played 1. Still no score. Even first quarter as we head into quarter number 2.
Three down. Mike 35. Let's go.
He gets out to about the 28-yard line.
That'll bring up 36.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Slings it. He's at the 20. Inside the 10. Touchdown! The halfback got his number called on the pass play and came through with a score.
Well, this is what separates good backs from great ones. You have to have the ability to contribute to the passing game.
And he adds the extra point. A 10-play, 94-yard drive. And they come away with 7 points.
You know, when you can throw the football as well as these guys can, you don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient in throwing the ball.
He's to the 20. Across the 30. He's tackled at the 35. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Tries to buy some time. They'll make the sack. Third and nine. Ball on the 36. Flips it, middle to a running back. That's a great tackle at the 38-yard line. That's a gain of 2 yards. It looks like they're going to go after this punt. He's to the 40, got the corner. He's taken down at the 44. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Georgia up 7 points. Fires out to his receiver, and they make the stop at the 40. That's a that makes it second down and six. Ball on the 40-yard line. Made around the 32-yard line. Fires to his tight end, nothing doing.
That is a great hit. And we're not just talking about some undersized wide receiver. This is a big guy, and you've really got to bring it to knock the ball away like he did there.
Second and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. Caught out in the open. And he's level at the 26. That'll make it 35. Up in the pocket and sacked. They look like they've got the block on. This offensive line's got to give him some time. That turned out to be a nice little punt there.
It was just a little pooch kick, but it was very effective.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And he carries the ball for a nice game. The gut. He gets to about the 27-yard line. Curl, The offense didn't get the playoff in time.
Delayed game, offense.
And the coach doesn't look very happy after that call.
Well, you only help out the defense when you don't get the playoff in time. You're essentially just giving away free yardage.
So the penalty makes it first and 15. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And they finally push him out at the 49. Big game there for the first down.
There was some miscommunication down there by the defense that allowed for that big game.
From the 46-yard line. Second down. Crosses out to the tailback on the screen, and he hits him hard at the 37-yard line. Tackles him hard at the 23. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
I think play action is a big part of this offense and what they're trying to do today. They're running the football and they're mixing in some play action. And what that does is it freezes the linebackers and the safeties and puts a lot of pressure on them to have to be able to defend both the run and the play action. And as a play caller, when I know I can go to play action fast, boy, I feel really good about it. It's getting my quarterback in rhythm, slowing down the defense, and giving us a chance to make big plays.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Quick throw, and he's got the halfback again. And he's tackled at the 2. Touchdown, Bruins. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He hits the PAT. So a 10-play, 94-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Fielded at the 4. At the 30. They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one. I give the defense credit, but right now I think it's more a case of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset, and they're very well prepared. But I'm with you. It's one thing to have great defense. It's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now and hitting on all cylinders.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 33. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Grabs it and hammered right there. Got it and brought down immediately. It'll be short of the first after the completion.
Well, good effort by the defense to make sure they got him before he got to the marker.
So the booth is trying to determine exactly where they'll spot the ball. So the call on the field will be reversed. From their own 43-yard line, it's first down. they get the sack.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Hands. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He'll throw this one as far as he can and hope for a miracle. Throws it deep. In the air. It's intercepted. And he is drilled at the 8-yard line. We've played a half. We're even at 7 in this one.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half. And, boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
But, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this grave. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. We're going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
Well, Reese and David, I know you're jealous. This is the kind of games you guys like to do. But that's Thursday night. This is the big show. He'll return it from the three. And he's tackled at the 26-yard line. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. Quick out to his receiver. He's tackled at the 38. It's first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. He gets out to about the 38-yard line.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48. And he's taken down at the 34-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 14 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 34.
Let's go!
Brought down around the 22-yard line. Pickup.
makes it second and six.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Here they come. And that one's incomplete. From the 18-yard line, third down. Rifles this one out to the left. Looks to the end zone and is caught. Touchdown. He makes the PAT. A 9-play, 73-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
From his own goal line, he makes it to the 25-yard line. The Bulldog staff has got a winner on their hands. You've been around kids like this. They're just fun to be around.
They're fun to be around, and I think it's infectious. His attitude, I think, permeates throughout this entire offense and really throughout the entire team. It's no wonder this team is so competitive with him at the front leading the way.
Here's the give. He's pushed out of bounds at the 36-yard line. Taken down at the 39. He's on the run. And he's sacked. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds and those receivers might have been open.
From their own 37-yard line. Third down. Pulls down the catch and he's got room here. He's knocked out of bounds at the 48. The 39-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
Takes it right and brought down right away. Run to the left there. And he stopped behind the line.
But you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
That brings up second and 13.
This is the ninth play of this drive. Zips it to the tight end. Tackle at about the 25-yard line. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
You know, it looked to me like he should have made the pitch, but he kept it instead and wound up going backwards.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down.
Oh, yeah, I'm coming. Oh, yeah, I'm coming. Mike, 55. Right
there. He's scrambling. Runs with it, and he's got room. And they make the stop around the 15-yard line. Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking scheme. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
Now he tries to buy some time. They'll make the sack. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
And we'll take a break while the injured player is attended to. From the 17-yard line, it's third down. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Dumps it out left to the running back. The Bruins quarterback down on the sideline after getting injured earlier. I think it looks like he's in that much pain, and I would bet that we're going to see him back in the game before the day's over. He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights. The fourth quarter is going to decide who wins this low-scoring affair. 14-10, Bulldogs. Like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. Gets to about the 24-yard line. Back to the action here. Tight ball game in the fourth quarter. A score here might effectively end this one. Georgia holds a 4-point lead. To the right to his fullback. They completed it, but for a minimal gain.
It's not much, but at least it's positive yards.
That makes it second and eight.
From their own 26-yard line, it's second down. Here's the halfback on the screen. He's to the 40. Tackle made right around the 44-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 44. Nearly picked off, but he couldn't hold it. That could have been a big play for the defense.
Yeah, even though he had a good shot at picking it off, it's still a heck of a play to force the incomplete pass.
He's tackled in the open field. First and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. They'll bring him down around the 34-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. Georgia is up four. Makes it to the 21. And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Take four. Pick it up, guys. Pick it up. run, and he's brought down.
That's a gain of four on the play. That makes it second and six.
From the 17-yard line, second down. Get the call again, and he's tackled at the 14. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks.
Well, that's another first down, Brad. That's the fifth first down on this drive. You know, this offense isn't hitting a lot of big plays, but they're very, very consistent with their execution. It's putting a lot of pressure on them.
Touchdown, Georgia! Converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Fielded at the four. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. Last drive resulted in a field goal, and the offense will come back out looking to do one better. Just under 2 minutes in the game. He airs it out. He's tackled at the 31. They really got beat by the deep pad.
Against man-to-man coverage like that, it's just a foot race.
He throws it. Incomplete. From the 31-yard line, it's second down. Deep ball, laying it out there. And a huge touchdown play. A huge pass and catch for the touchdown, and now we're down to a one-score game. And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. Scrambling around. They don't get it. With a three-play, 75-yard drive. And they get 6 points on the board after failing the two-point conversion.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot. And they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
So the score now, 21-16. He's taken down at the 36. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Gets out to around the 28. A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He's at the 20. He makes his way to about the 18.
Well, the execution of this offense has been on display here in this drive. They know what they needed to do, and that's pick up the first down, work the clock, and finish this game off. And with that first down, they may have done it.
Makes it out to about the 10.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. makes it second down.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Under a minute left in the game.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Gain 7 yards. That makes it first and goal.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. And so that's going to do it. The Bulldogs take it here, 21-16. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.